the House of Representatives has been placed on lockdown ahead of President Marcos's first State of the Nation address. The lockdown, which started Thursday noon and will last until Sunday, is part of security measures for the event. Only essential House personnel are allowed to enter the premises during that period. The security groups of the House in Malacañang also held two walkthrough events Friday. The House Legislative Security Bureau says these were meant to familiarize the presidential security group with the venue so they could respond quickly in case of an emergency. The Philippine National Police earlier announced over 20,000 personnel will be deployed to secure Marcos's first SONA. Organizers of the SONA issue a strict dress code reminder. They say clothes bearing political messages will be prohibited at the event. Attendees at the plenary hall and on video conference platforms will be required to wear traditional Filipino garments like the barong or Filipiniana or appropriate business attire. The rule change does not sit well with Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel. He notes this is the first time in recent history that an explicit prohibition was issued for the dress code. Fashion was often used to make political statements during previous State of the Nation addresses. And let's now bring in Quezon City Department of Public Order and Safety Chief Elmo San Diego. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Magandang hapon sa lahat.
May we know what is the agreement reached with progressive groups on the SONA demonstrations tomorrow? What is your commitment? What is their commitment to you? How is it going to be different from the permit granted to Marcos supporters?
Yeah, initially the rally permit requested by Bayan Muna, one of the progressive groups who is going to do the People's SONA, was denied based on the recommendation made by the security forces, the QCPD. We acceded to their recommendation and subsequently denied also the request. But after a day, we got directing from the mayor of Quezon City that we should come up with a win-win solution and look for a middle ground. Because apparently QCPD again allowed granted the permit of PBBM group. And to be fair with everybody, I think it's wise and proper, according to the mayor, to look into the permit, which was denied. And indeed, a group from Bayan Muna and San Lucas requested and submitted an appeal for reconsideration. This is actually the subject or main agenda of the meeting yesterday. It's a long and tedious process because we discussed the issues concerned together with the security forces, QCPD, DILG, and the guys from Dimancom of Quezon City LGU. And we come up with the agreement na that we will allow the progressive group to march from along Commonwealth from Quezon City Circle to Tandansora.
That's right, sir. But you did mention to be fair to everybody, but is it fair that these progressive groups are only allowed to march up to Tandansora while the Marcos supporters are going to be allowed to actually hold demonstrations right beside or around Batasang Pambansa?
Actually, there's no other venue available for the group of San Lucas and Bayan Muna, and we cannot grant them the same venue for the rally. So we made it a point, and I think it's wise and proper upon recommendation of the QCPD that we separate them and subsequently approve the venue for PBBM group, and the progressive groups on the other hand, they're allowed to march along Commonwealth. Not within the proximity of HOR, but a little bit farther.
You are in close coordination with the QCPD, but of course we have 20 to 22,000 law enforcement officers who will be deployed in and around the venue of the SONA. But what is the directive to these law enforcement officers when it comes to the demonstrators tomorrow? Usually they would say maximum tolerance, but what does that actually mean? What kind of deployments will you have or even equipment you will have on the ground tomorrow, rather on Monday?
Yeah, let me clarify the issue. The QCLGU will only augment the security preparations of QCPD in terms of traffic control and direction and other security concerns. QCPD is directly involved in the control of crowd in the people's zona. And as such, they are in charge of the overall security preparations in the zona. But the position of the Quezon City local government is that according to the mandate and directive of the mayor to QCPD, they should practice maximum tolerance.
But what kind of equipment will be available to law enforcement as well as QCPD?
Apparently, as far as I know, no firearms will be displayed and will be issued to the crowd control operators. And aside from that, there will be no barricade. Just CDM palangs will be deployed along Quezon Boulevard near Tandasara, where QCLGU allowed the progressive groups to conduct their rally.
Are you expecting any violence or any untoward incident at tomorrow at Monday's Sonam? And would you happen to know if there will be, let's say, water cannons that will be made available to law enforcement?
Actually, this concern is with the QCPD already. And as a former police officer from the same police district, I deem it wise and necessary to be over-prepared and not under-prepared to address this kind of contingencies.
Mm-hmm. So the answer is yes, such equipment will be made available, except for firearms.
Yeah, that's right.
Understood. Well, hopefully we do have a peaceful and smooth sauna on Monday. We'll catch up with you again after the sauna. Elmo San Diego of the Quezon City Department of Public Order and Safety. Grateful for your update, sir. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much also.
We appreciate it.